Followers of Christ, Christians, are marked by His name.
Our Daily Bread.
Today's encouragement from the Our Daily Bread devotional was written by Bill Crowder. In July 1860, the world's first nursing school opened at St. Thomas Hospital in London. Today, that school is part of the King's College, where nursing students are called Nightingales. The school, like modern nursing itself, was established by Florence Nightingale, who revolutionized nursing during the Crimean War. When prospective nurses complete their training, they take the Nightingale Pledge, a reflection of her ongoing impact on nursing. Many people, like Florence Nightingale, have had a significant impact on our world. But no one has had a greater effect than Jesus, whose birth, death, and resurrection have been transforming lives for 2,000 years. Around the world, Christ's name marks those who are His followers, going back to the earliest days of the church. We read in Acts 11:26 that when Barnabas had found Saul, he brought him to Antioch. So it was that for a whole year they assembled with the church and taught a great many people, and the disciples were first called Christians in Antioch. Those who bear Christ's name identify with Him because we have been changed by His love and grace. We declare to the world that He has made an eternal difference in our lives, and we long for that in the hearts of others too.
Today's Our Daily Bread devotional scripture reading is from Acts chapter 11, verses 19 through 26. Now those who had been scattered by the persecution that broke out when Stephen was killed traveled as far as Phoenicia, Cyprus, and Antioch, spreading the word only among the Jews. Some of them, however, men from Cyprus and Cyrene, went to Antioch and began to speak to the Greeks also, telling them the good news about the Lord Jesus. The Lord's hand was with them, and a great number of people believed and turned to the Lord. News of this reached the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch. When he arrived and saw what the grace of God had done, he was glad and encouraged them all to remain true to the Lord with all their hearts. He was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and faith, and a great number of people were brought to the Lord. Then Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul, and when he found him, he brought him to Antioch. So for a whole year, Barnabas and Saul met with the church and taught great numbers of people. The disciples were called Christians first at Antioch. That's today's scripture reading from Acts chapter 11, verses 19 through 26.
Let's take a moment and pray together now. Father, give us the grace and wisdom to honor You. May our lives be so marked by the person of Christ that His great name and salvation will be embraced by others as well. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Have thoughts about what you've just heard? We'd love to hear from you. Let us know how Our Daily Bread has inspired your daily walk with God by leaving a comment on today's devotional at odb.org. Today's encouragement was brought to you from Our Daily Bread Ministries.